Hey guys and girls, welcome to today's video. This is the ultimate flat toe challenge for the big three trucks in Spintires today. So we've got the Sweet Vengeance 3500 Chevy, we've got of course the Ram 2500 in red, and we've got CCS ZV01's Powerstroke Ford. What we're going to do today is we're going to test can those three trucks actually pull the massive Tatra Turno 12x12. If you guys are not familiar with the Tatra 12x12 Turno, or the Turno 12x12, it's one of the biggest trucks you can actually get for Spintires. It has 12-wheel drive, and just as you see the truck now, it weighs a hell of a lot. Now, I was in a multiplayer game with Jugs and Pineapple and, well, to a degree, Farmer Sean. And what we were doing is we were driving these massive, big Tatra 12x12s around the Plans Extreme map. So we were taking these massive trucks onto a crawler map. And guys, I've got to say, it was one of the most fun times I've had in Spintires yet. Taking massive trucks on trails they don't actually fit down was so much fun. Now, I managed to get my truck stuck in such a way that it didn't matter what tree I connected to, it'd just pull it out and the tree shot up into the sky like a rocket. It was really weird. But I got my Tatra stuck. And Pineapple actually had to end up spawning in Bragel's M1070 to see if he could actually tow me out of the area that I was stuck in. And even that massive big truck had problems trying to recover the Tatra. In the end, we had to spawn in the Type E class and use the outriggers buried into the ground just to move the Tatra 12x12 out of the place I got it stuck in. So I got asked, do you think your Ram can pull the Tatra 12x12? And I'm like, I don't know. So guys and girls, I figured what we would do is we turn it into a bit of a challenge, and we're going to see if the three trucks that we featured in our tow test can actually pull the Tatra 12x12. Now, I'm on the Terra Verde map, and I found a road that was relatively straight. Not easy, but straight. And as you can see, it's not dead flat. It's got a bit of hills, got a bit of ups and downs, and we're going to see if the three trucks that we had in our tow test can actually pull the Tatra 12x12. So let's get the first truck up and connected. So let's go over and see the trucks that we've got today. Okay, so we're going to go back to the map, and I'm just going to show you the trucks we've got today. Number one, we have the Red Ram that Quasimodo 420 and I are working on. It will be released to the public, guys. Just give us a bit more time. It's just has to be released. It's ready to rock and roll. It just has to be released, but these things do take time. The other trucks we've got featured today is the Sweet Vengeance 3500 Chevy Silverado, and we've got CCS ZV01's Powerstroke representing the Ford. So we've got Ford, Chevy, and Ram. Okay, what we're going to do first is we're going to swap over to the Powerstroke, and let's get it onto the trail first. We'll get it hooked up, and let's see if the Powerstroke can flat tow the Tatra Turno 12x12. So let's fire it up. Now, I know what some of you guys are thinking right now is, dude, put the stacks on. Makes it look tough. Yeah, it does, but doesn't really help us in our flat toe challenge, so I'm not going to add those. And I can't change the tires to any better grip because there are no options. But let's take it up and get it hooked up to the Tatra Turno 12x12. Now, what will happen, guys and girls, is I will try each truck out and see if it can flat toe it. And we're going to keep starting from the same point, which is we're going to keep the Tatra 12x12 lined up with the first set of trees on this trail. Okay, so let's get the Ford lined up on the trail, get it connected up, and let's see. Can the Ford Powerstroke pull the Tatra 12x12? So let's back her up. Okay, now I'm just going to measure the distance here. Okay, the bed will be in line with that little bush there. Okay, so that's where we'll bring each truck to. We'll get the front of the cab, or the rear of the cab and the bed lined up with that bush there. So let's attach the tow rope to the front of the Tatra and let's see. Now remember, we're changing it from accelerate to just pull. So each truck will be the only source of power. The Tatra will be switched off. So let's see how it does. Ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Spooling up the Ford and letting go of the handbrake. Oh. Oh dear. It's not moving. Okay, I'll give it 10 seconds of wheel spin. 1, 2. Oh, it's moving! We're moving! That's good. Wow, that was an interesting start, hey! The Ford didn't want to pull it. Now, once again, when we get to a standstill, 10 seconds of free wheel spin, and then we'll have to call it. So it's when we don't move anymore. And then we'll measure where the front of the bonnet is in relative distance to back to the garage, and we'll see how we go. Oh, we're wiggling. Okay, 10 seconds of wheel spin starts now. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, we're moving again. Okay, another 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, we're moving again. Look at that. We've stopped again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's where it ends for the Ford. Let's measure from where the Ford is back to the garage, and we'll calculate that as being our distance. So we're there, and we're going to measure it back to that rock there. So 101. That's not too shabby, actually. 101 meters. We're going to put it to that rock each time. 101 for the Ford. So what we'll do now is we'll reset everything, and then we'll take the next truck out. Okay, so let's reset the Ford back to the garage. Let's reset the Tatra. Okay, resetting the Tatra. Nope, no, don't hit the spawn button. That's not a good idea. Okay, let's bring the Tatra back to where we got it. That's actually pretty impressive. This thing weighs a ton. Or more than a ton. Weighs a crap ton. Okay, gotta get that bumper lined up. Ah! Camera's not cooperating with me. Okay, need to move it a bit forward, About there. Righto, let's shut the Tatra down and go and get the next truck on our list. Alrighty, so let's bring on the next truck, which I think will be the Chevy Silverado. So let's go grab the Silverado and let's bring it on over. Now guys, this is the Sweet Vengeance Chevy Silverado 3500. Now what we will do to this one, because we've got a couple of options, we're going to change the tyres to OP if we can. OP... OP Thornbirds, give it a bit more lift. There we go. Let's add the light bar. Let's add the toolbox. Do you want dual exit? Or stock exhaust? We'll go stock, just for the hell of it. Let's add some gear. Right, now we'll go and fuel it up. Because it's got tools and fuel, we'll make the truck a little bit more heavier. Beautiful. Right, now let's go get the Chevy hooked up to the front of the Tatra 12x12 and let's see if it can move it any further than the Ford did. Okay, now I need to line that bed up again with that little bush, so we come forward. Oh, hang on, get it straight. Oh, too far back. About there. That works. Let's hook the tow rope up. Okay, make sure we change it to pull. And let's spool up the big Chevy and let's let it rip. Ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Will that extra long wheelbase hurt it or help it? Isn't that diesel working overtime? Isn't that turbo? Same rules again, 10 seconds of wheel spin from where we stop. We're still going, which is good. Oh, I think, we're still moving. Okay, we've stopped, so 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Righto, calling it there for the Chevy. Let's go back to that rock. 102. Wow. So maybe that extra long wheelbase just helped it out. Cool. Alrighty, well that leaves us with one other truck to bring on to this test, and that's the Ram 2500. I'm not sure it's going to do as well as these others, but we'll see. Okay, let's reset the Tatra again. Same story, we back it up until its front bumper is in line with the trees. So you guys get to see how I reset. Okay, whoa, hold it. Back you go. Ah, camera angle's been a pain in the butt. That's pretty level, I think. So we'll turn off the Tatra. And let's go get the Ram. Alrighty, so we're back here getting the Ram. What we're going to do now is we're going to fit it out with a couple of things. Start her up, move her across. Now the only problem is I'll have to drive around those to get the fuel. So what we're going to do is we're going to add the open countries. We're going to add the roll bar, the light bar, the tools and fuel, and the light bar and the grill. Okay, and let's go get it fueled up so it weighs the most it can. Oop. Can I get in front? Yeah, I can. Cool. Alright. Fuel it up. And let's go see if the Ram can do as good as the others. Alrighty. So we're going to drive it across now. I am running the OP tyres. Wherever I've got the option for an OP tyre, I will run it. That's the advantage of having a creator that codes for OP tyres. This is because you can get maximum grip. Now this is a lot shorter than both the Chevy and the Ford. So it's going to be interesting to see how it pans out. Okay, I need to get it straight. There we go, straight. Now a little bit further backwards maybe. A bit more. That there. Let's hook it up to the Tatra. There we go. Once again, changing it from accelerate to pull so the Tatra doesn't turn on. We turn the all-wheel drive and the diff lock on, and let's spool up the Ram. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, launch. Ooh, she pulls it great off the line. That's really impressive straight off the line, but I don't think it's going to have enough power. I don't think it can. It's a bit lighter truck than the other two. Let's see how it goes. Seems to be pulling it really, really confidently. Feels a bit more confident than the Chevy did, but I don't think it's going to go as far. Okay, once again, 10 seconds of wheel spin starts from now. So, 10, 9, 8... 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, call it. Let's measure back to the rock. 101. Wow. Okay. There we go, guys and girls. There's the test. As you can see there, both the Ford and the Ram came in dead level at 101 meters each. The Chevy just beat them by a meter at 102. So that's pretty good. That goes to show you that all three of these trucks are pretty well matched as far as their towing power is concerned. That's actually quite surprising. I mean, it's to be expected that the Chevy did come in front, because if you have a look at the size of these trucks, you know, if you have a look, when you put them side by side, you can see the wheelbase differences. Okay, the Ram and the Ford are pretty level. Yeah, pretty level. Pretty identical, actually. That's interesting. The body is a little bit longer, though. A little bit, a smidge. Although, that's really interesting how I've got a slightly larger cab, but a smaller tray. Cool. Okay, now let's roll forward and see how it measures up with the Chevy. I don't want to crawl on top of the Chevy. Let's go forward. Maybe the snorkel was catching it. Okay, let's move forward. Let's see if we can get those wheels lined up pretty smack on. Ooh, I don't think that's dead level yet, is it? Let's have a look. Well, there you go. Wow. The Chevy is a little bit longer, but not by much. The wheelbase is definitely longer, though. So I would say, taking that into account, I'd say all three of these trucks are pretty even. Wow, how's that for a call? So all three of these trucks can tow really, really well. Alrighty, guys and girls, I will catch you next time when we do another challenge. Until then, bye for now.